All right, recording has started. Welcome. Gonna be playing some college hoops. Of course, after that disappointment of a conference tournament that led to us losing by 5 to Southern, we lost our 14th seed in the NCAA tournament. Actually, this says NCAA basketball. I could have swore we were in NIT. Did we actually make the big... Okay, this says NCAA basketball. So... Okay, because I was assuming I'm just going to have to go through the NCAA tournament, or the NIT. Okay, this is NIT for sure. Okay. I'm in NIT for sure. I thought for a second because it said NCAA basketball right there, that perhaps I still had a chance at doing a play-in game or something. But no, I'm most certainly in the NIT with some interesting teams, to say the very least. Wow, North Carolina's here? What the hell did they do to get here? Wow, that's amazing to see North Carolina and NIT. But yeah, either way, after that disappointment that was that last tournament game that we had, we have lost our NCAA tournament position, and we are here in the NIT, where I will be facing UMBC in the first bracket, and then I'll be facing the winner of Illinois and Fresno State, most likely Illinois. And then the winner of that, hopefully I'll win that, I'll face either one of these four teams, and hopefully I can make it to the final four of the NIT before the end of the stream. Well, let's see, that would be one game, two games, three games, so if I win all the next three games, I'll at least be able to for sure know if I had made the final four of the NIT tournament. So that won't forever like haunt me or anything like that, but it's just one of those things. I'm like, I so could have done it. Could have, if I just didn't completely poop the bed, I could have probably had a number 14 seed, because they had 16. I was scheduled for 14. I think all I had to do was just keep winning. And I probably could have even gotten a 13 seed, but oh well. I won't dwell on that. I'll be dwelling on completely bullying everybody. I don't know why I said that like a fat person. Bullying. Yeah, but bullying people in the NIT tournament. And showcasing the fact that I do not deserve to be here. I deserve to be in the real tournament. I don't really have much of a choice, do I? That's alright. I just realized I could edit uniforms in this, but... Alright. Hopefully I don't talk about bullying people in this tournament and then go out and lose first round. That would suck. That would suck to sit here and be like, oh yeah, no. No, your team really is that bad. Come back next year.
It's time for College Hoops 2K8. The Maryland right. Baltimore County Retrievers go up against the Grambling State Titans. Hello, basketball fans. We're here at
great.
Memorial Gym. I'm Vern Lundquist.
They're not the Huskies. They're not the Bulldogs. They're the Retrievers.
What's your take on this, Bill? This game features a matchup between two...
Jesus Christ. So, University of Maryland Baltimore College? No, that doesn't seem weird. Seem right.
The Retrievers.
The MB is definitely Maryland Baltimore. I just don't know the C. Because it seemed a little stupid if it was University of like Maryland Baltimore College. Like that wouldn't make sense. Alright, let me see. Oh boy, let's see, I gotta remember how the hell I do all this.
What's it up?
There you go. Nice, good start. We're going to play some smart basketball, though. I could feel it. There you go. Just wind down that clock. We'll sit here and keep the pressure on you.
Catches it. Left wing.
Ah.
The three-pointer was
ooh,
no good.
There you go.
By number five. Great rebound. The big fella's not afraid to do the dirty work, Vern.
All right, Dandridge, come on.
Dandridge backs him
down. All right,
down.
He can't do it.
Copeland passes to the wing.
Back in. Back in.
Shoots it.
I just made a Hail Mary shot. They're just to see if he could do it. I think he's made that before in an earlier stream that I did.
Right.
So, yeah, might have worked out. Oh, boy. Ah! He should have shot earlier. He probably would have had it.
Dendridge. Backs down. Bounces it to the wing.
All right. No. No.
Dendridge has it left side.
Come on.
Bounce pass. Down low. Robertson.
Ah, that wasn't good.
Number 35.
A lot of these guys don't have range. Boy, can I not wait until next year.
Point lead.
But I'm not just gonna end this just so I could get to next year.
Number 35.
I want this team to at least be successful. We had a great winning record.
Jones skips it to the middle.
Great first year. Oh my God. That absolutely had fast break written all over it, and I screwed it up. Okay, good. I recovered somehow, amazingly.
He's doubled up.
I'll double team him.
Passes it
force him to make some sort of play. There you go.
Such great instincts. He knew exactly where the ball was going.
There you go. All right. Great start.
Number 35. Inbound.
We'll probably be taking a timeout here sooner rather than later.
For an update. What do you have for us, Tracy?
Just before the game, I talked.
Oh,
about
look at that.
Playing against a team that has the
oh, damn it.
So many second chance opportunities. He said it is extremely important that his players do not get lazy boxing out their man. Giving
damn.
Up extra possessions to a team like this will kill us.
Ooh, okay, that was a huge mismatch on our part.
Right around.
That's all right.
Left in the half.
No, oh, balls. What was it? There we go. Quick pick and roll.
Leads him with the pass. Denver.
There you go.
Him.
Nice.
They're up 8-2.
Come on. Come on, somebody. Oh, screw it.
Number 35 catches it outright.
Ah. I jumped too early. It's all right.
Can't sink the first. Both teams are going to shake things up a little bit. With some
it almost looks like we're in our... We're in ours. No, I don't know where we're at for NIT right now.
Good on number two.
Oh, we are in Grambling.
Dendrick inbounds the ball.
Why is it that we both have the like we're helping host the NIT?
Tosses it.
That's kind of cool, I guess.
Hauled down inside by Houston. Stolen away by Dendrick.
There we go.
He's got six. Here comes the double team.
There you go.
The Retrievers were the last ones to touch it, and they'll turn it over.
That's not the kind of teamwork you like to see out there. They need to get on the same page.
Just over 8 minutes left in the half. Dendridge.
This is to make us feel better for the fact that we didn't make the tournament. Hey, you guys can help host the NIT. I guess.
First time out of the game. Well, let's get back to the action.
So even though it appears to be a mixture, this should be pretty much all our fans. I mean, we sell out the damn thing.
They're going to double team him. It's deflected.
Oh, there you go. Oh, damn.
Catches it, top of the key.
He had it.
Jones.
We're making him second guess.
Top of the key.
Oh.
Out left. Passes it to the high post. Nice pass.
Oh.
Jones takes it up.
Oh, that was a crap foul.
He misses the first.
Man, they're all bad at shooting free throws. Not that I'm going to complain.
He's off on the second.
There you go.
Wheeler tosses it up court.
Get there. Get down there.
Dendridge backs in.
Rose. Get it. Put it up. Put it in.
Count it.
There you go.
That's 15 unanswered points.
15 to 3. What a start.
Shoots. Nice job.
Ah, that was actually some good defense.
They're now down by 10. The Tigers with a lot of momentum. The offensive board gathered by Wheeler.
There we go.
Number 5 inbounds the ball.
Just hound them. That's the best thing to do right here is just hound them.
Number 35 gets the board inside.
Wow. That is some.
To get this thing going. It hasn't
that is some
been pretty for them so
bad
far.
Interior play. If he's right underneath the hoop and still can't manage
instead,
it,
he'll go to the line for two.
I can't say too much. Our team's done that same thing. That's why I'm recruiting better people. You know, I don't think I ever got around to what the hell some of these other
some of those other
meters are.
Hope's free, but it's tracked down by Maryland Baltimore.
Imagine that white one at the very least is like the turbo slash like stamina meter. As far as the red thing's concerned, I really don't know.
Plummer inbounds the ball. Leads him in.
Damn. Maybe it's how hot they are.
About six
like if they got a lot of momentum.
Higgin has it right wing.
Okay, now I really don't know what the white one does because I just watched it go all over the place.
Backs him down. Dendridge puts it up.
Oh, that was a bad shot.
Inside. He got it up there, but it
oh, look at that.
With a little more touch, it might have. Goes
oh, I don't know how he managed to make that work, but we did.
By 14. Here comes the double.
Holy crap.
Morgan.
This is great. Just abuse them.
Leads him with the pass.
The beautiful wow,
pass.
Damn.
Straight to the layup by number 5.
It's all right.
But they're still down by 12. Gets it. Left wing. Higgins. Dumps it inside.
Ooh, that wasn't good. Oh, I thought he had it by his fingertips. I thought he had it.
Down low. Plummer, the 9-footer. Robertson hauls it in.
There you go.
That's his third rebound of the contest.
Oh, he didn't get down and in.
Backs down.
I was kind of expecting that.
Raises up.
Oh, he didn't get that rebound either.
Sloppy on the release.
You're
right.
This is
just a little, but it cost him there. Morgan.
Let's not completely screw this up. We got them in a pretty nice position right now.
Morgan gets it right wing. Feeds outside. Grabbed by Garner.
Ah, that should have been ours too. What is with the shit rebounding at this point, boys? What's going on?
Backs him down. Well, the D did a nice job of disrupting him a little bit. That's tough work down low.
Rose swings it to the left wing. Inside.
Oh, that defense.
Picks it up, hits the layup.
No fouls. Come on.
The D. And they now
feel like there should be some fouls team. Being called here.
They're bringing the double team. The Retrievers will take a timeout.
Damn.
Both teams
that's all
are
right.
Going to make some substitutions.
I should have looked into point of emphasis for rebounding. That would have helped. Shuffle. Oh, look at that. Telegraph that one.
The intercept. What great reflexes.
Boom. Oh, what a great start this is to the game. This is what I needed for a first round game after that humiliating loss. I could see analysts within our tiny conference being like, well, they're pretty much a shoe-in for the... For the Whoa, conference title.
The what a good job on
then
the
we lose in the second round in an upset. There we go. Finally get yourself a foul. I think that's like their second, but still.
And he makes the first.
And oh, damn.
Of two.
See, our shooting's not really much better than theirs. So I can't really say too much about it. Oh, perfect.
Oh, the quick hands. Before they even knew what hit them, he made off with that one.
Oh. Telegraph those passes.
Maryland BC has been on the wrong side of this long run, and Tracy's got a report for us.
Coach Monroe.
Oh, my God.
Talking to his assistants, trying to come up with a plan on defense to stop
this
run.
And the tip-in. Hot damn.
Thanks, Tracy. That's a great example of creating offense from your defense. Here's the double
team. There you go. Force him to do something. Oh, my God.
To touch it, and they'll turn it over.
Sometimes this is what I needed.
The fault of the guy in the receiving end, but not that time.
To just completely just abuse them.
Wheeler.
Oh, nice. Still got the tip in. Just keep running that half court, or that full court trap. Make them try to make some plays here. That's how we're gonna do
Jones
this.
Dumps it down low. Goes up.
Nice block.
And that's his fifth rebound in this one.
Damn.
They gotta find a way to stop this onslaught.
Well, the best defense can be a good offense.
Oh shit, that was not good. That's all right. We're doing well enough right now.
Great pass. Right side.
Don't let a mismatch happen. There's a mismatch going on.
Picked away. The steal.
No.
Number 11. Passes to the left wing. Dishes. Cross court. The steal.
There you go.
There
you go.
Goes up. I'd love to see that.
Oh, my God. No foul?
Such a deep.
I think he got smacked around a little bit there. You're going to call no foul.
They're bringing the double team. It's deflected.
Oh.
By number 35.
Oh, he missed. Holy shit, he missed.
On that one. And it was just enough to throw it off. Backs in. Gets it. Right wing.
Come on, back him in.
Robertson.
There you go.
To the right side.
Oh.
Left wing. Hobbs from
I knew there was going to be a little bit of defense there. There we go. Good enough.
He's got six.
Make it work.
They're going to double team it. Maryland BC has had serious problems with their interior defense. And Tracy has a report from their bench.
Coach Monroe is
definitely
aware of that problem.
All right.
He told his assistants that they have to bring more defenders into the paint.
Rebounding is probably what I should be doing.
Desperate measures here, Vern.
All right, Tracy.
We haven't been the best
both
at it.
Are making substitutions.
Oh.
Higgins inbounds the ball. The Tigers have got a nice lead. Unloads.
Oh, they relax on that defense.
He's shooting 100% from downtown.
100. We're perfect from behind the line right now. Taking some good three-point shots. Oh, come on.
He'll take a trip to the line.
Damn.
Shooting.
Good. Keep missing.
Are going to make some substitutions.
Oh, that Turner fucker is here. I have this irrational hatred of guys who are useless on our team.
And he's going to
My God, I screwed it all up. It's all right.
He's double teamed. Morgan. Bounces it to the left.
They have so many opportunities to score, and they're not taking it because they're holding on for the last shot.
Outright.
So I'm trying to make them do something.
Catches it right side.
There you go.
Grabs the rock. That's another rebound for a team that's doing a great job on the boards. They've got a big edge there today.
Oh, of course you suck, Turner.
And we're headed to halftime.
38-11. I think people would start filing out the door at that point. It's like they're not going to get anywhere. It's 38-11.
This could be even further out of reach. They need to make some adjustments.
They've had 12 turnovers already. Jesus. We've had very balanced team play right now, it seems like.
Let's see who we have as our player of the half. Bill
Dandridge is the guy for me, Vern. Look at this scoring display. He hasn't been afraid to put it on the deck, and take it to the
nice.
10. Tremendous
All
effort
right.
from our player of the half.
Let's get to the second half and just finish them off. End this. I don't even have to be like all that. I might just keep with what I'm doing right now. Like, just lay off of them a little bit. Like, we don't need to go full tilt on them.
Tracy Wolfson has more on what went on at
halftime. Quick pick and roll.
I talked with Coach Wilson. He felt it wouldn't be classy to run up the score and was going to change.
Oh, God, Turner, why did I even?
Coach said that even though his starters had plenty of energy, he would still rotate in his bench players. He said that it wasn't a question of fatigue, but more of a method of showing different looks on offense. Back to you, Vern.
There you go. There you go.
Turner, way up court. Number 5 passes it to the high post. Right wing puts it up. The 3-pointer.
Still 100% from the three, from behind the 3-point line.
Here comes the double team.
Damn.
It's stolen.
Oh my God.
The extra guy just snuck up on him and forced the
Got
turnover.
It.
Sneaky but clever play by the D.
Gameplay is the best. Oh yeah, definitely. That's what I can't remember whose I'm using at this point because it was quite a while back. But yeah, once you tweak the sliders and kind of have it work for you a little bit better, then yeah,
arrow pointed their way.
It goes great. And when you combine it with a great like career legacy, oh, it's awesome.
Plummer inbounds the ball. Jones dumps it off. Number 5 with the wide open look.
There you go.
Wheeler hauls in the board. I bet he wants another try at that shot. There wasn't anyone within pick and a roll. Mile of him.
Oh my God, did you just exit? No, of course you didn't. God damn it. You know, this is where, this is like, my irrational hatred of Turner on my team, I don't think is irrational when he executes a good pick but can't do the roll part perfectly. Or even well, for that matter.
Tosses it up court.
Damn.
The Tigers turn this one over out of bounds. These guys are having trouble with fundamental.
Did we take
him
out? No,
for...
Turner's still there.
That turnover shows you they don't have much in the way of chemistry at the moment.
Listen, I know we're ahead, but can we not
right
use
side.
Them anymore?
Houston backs
or at least that one dude. I'll take the rest of the team. I don't care.
Number 35 gets it in the paint. Last ray off the mark.
I'm totally cutting him next year if he doesn't
around,
leave.
He still couldn't convert.
Sometimes All right, this is a chance to redeem yourself. Open. Nope.
Turner.
All right, see if he can't.
Catches it outside.
All right, I'm trying Back to figure down. Out exactly how I want this
Hobbs
to work.
Catches it to the high post.
Let's see. Do that. Oop.
Wheeler.
There you go. There you go.
Fires.
Of course you can't make it.
Glass by number 35.
To be fair, that defense was kind of butt, but, you
Looked
know.
Away, but it's recovered by Jones. Feeds it to the left wing. Plummer.
Damn.
Can't sink the first.
Ba-ba-bum. Come on.
He's off on the second.
Good. Can't make either one. They still haven't scored yet this half.
Hobbs goes up. Houston yanks
oh
it down
my God.
The retriever.
Finish the
down.
Shots, guys.
He tried to get fancy.
Can we put our starters back in?
There.
This is getting slightly ridiculous. Like, I know it's like, well, we want
to
give the... Oh, there you go. You got your first 2 points. I know you want to give the bench guys some love, but enough's enough. I'm going a little nuts over here. Oh, you didn't put anybody new in. This is just going to be a game for the bench guys, isn't it?
Inbounds the ball. Takes it up. Got a hand on it.
When you come over from the weak side,
every time I try to give you a good reason to prove me wrong, you always seem to screw it up.
Leads him in.
There you go.
Maryland, BC.
My team.
Down on the turnovers. And
oh my God.
Tracy?
All right.
He's not sugarcoating the issue. He told his assistants our fundamentals are abysmal. And then added the only
Nope, that is the one I wanted to get rid of. Cool.
Are the ones that can take care of the ball.
Thanks, Tracy.
Cool. Come on. There you go. Roberson, way up court. A little bit farther down than the one I wanted to do. Right wing. That's cool.
With the shot, hits the three-pointer.
Still perfect from three.
He's doubled up.
God, that first one's gonna sting a lot.
Skip pass, left side. Maryland, BC, all time.
Someone called a timeout right when they were developing a nice inside play. So I'll take it. Why not?
Out there, adding another guard to their lineup.
Did he just hit a cheerleader with the ball? Are we able to see that in the replay? Who did he just hit with the basketball? I think he just beamed a cheerleader. Oh no, he beamed his own player, it looked like. Oh god. I mean the physics were a little wonky, but yeah, he just beamed his own teammate in the head with the basketball.
Uses the crossover. Jones from long range gets it to go.
All
7
right.
points, and he's his team's leading scorer. Wheeler will bring it up court himself. Number 5.
Come on, there we go. Line.
Wheeler backs in.
Oh no, Turner's still there.
To the right block. That last basket was buried by Roberson.
As long as he can pass the ball well, I'll take it at least.
Baltimore County. Wonderful feed, just like you draw it up. Last basket on the mark by Morgan. Number 5.
The ball down the court.
Goes up.
Nobody around.
The finger roll was flipped up and in by Wheeler.
Hip hip hooray.
50% for the game.
Oh shit.
Dishes to the left. Intercepted by Robinson.
Oh, got it.
That'll be his third steal so far.
Come on.
It's blocked.
Oh my god.
Help him get a lot of shots.
He also has great instincts, a nose for the ball, and a feel for meeting the shooter's release point.
He cannot do anything.
Morgan fires the three. Connects.
Dude, Turner.
But they're still behind by 27. Robertson has it far side. Backs down. Back out left. Releases.
Yeah, I didn't want to do that. I wanted to spin off of him, but yeah, sure, that works too. Whatever.
A much quicker shot than they might have liked, but it was a pretty open look, so it's tough to fault him.
Wheeler.
There you go. Nope. Oh, got a lucky bounce in. Good.
That gives him a double-double. 10 points and 10 rebounds.
All right. Come on, there you go.
Scooped up by Robertson.
Not a good entry pass, Fern. You just can't force it in there.
Catches it. Left
there
side.
You go. Come on.
Hooked away.
Wow.
By Maryland, Baltimore County.
Oh, that wasn't Turner for once. That was Wheeler.
Tremendous nose for the ball and quick hands to boot.
All right, Turner. Last chance.
Turner backs him down. Takes the shot.
Ugh.
Arouse the miss inside.
I mean, I know that was kind of a well-defended shot, but still.
Morgan crosses it over.
Oh!
Stolen by number 5. The break is
on. There
you
go.
Turner feeds it to the left side. Right side. Here's the double team. Skips it.
There you go. Just put it up and in.
Oh,
it's the first one we missed. We're missing a few too many in my mind.
Jones. Launches one.
Wow, they just launched it. They're just
snatches the
like, oh god, we got 5 minutes, please, for the love of god. Let us land something.
It's too quiet in this building, Vern. If you don't get some excitement soon, this crowd is going to
fall. Oh, what a block.
Last shot by Morgan.
All right, but let's actually make something this time, boys.
Backs down. Turner.
I don't trust you with nothing no more.
Ah,
god.
Denying the basketball that time. Great pick.
Bounces it to the right. Plummer gets it.
Can we take this dude out?
Top of the key.
Let's take this dude out. I'll take anybody. I don't care at this point. Just anybody.
Hangs in the air. Gets a piece of it. His eyes lit up.
Ugh.
When he saw that shot go up. I love when guys get that
intentional foul.
Defense.
Who cares?
Oh, I guess
just get him out of here.
Frustration foul. Unless there's some other reason, I can't think of why they fouled right there. Maryland, Baltimore County. Looks like they want to add some size to the lineup.
Oh, there you go. Subs on court. Starter. And yeah, see, look at that. We need to change these guys out.
They're getting set to inbound the ball. The Tigers are putting the
sense.
Rest of their starting lineup back on the floor.
Grab the ball. There you go. I at least want a few minutes with my good guys in there. Good guys, of course, is in quotes, but
here
hey,
comes
you know.
The double team. Plummer dumps it off.
Having Jones. A rough game. I'm having a very nice game. It's I'm gonna win. I'm way too ahead already. But boy, do I hate some of the players on my team, and boy, can I not wait for them to be gone.
But it worked there. That last three ball was drained by number five.
There you go.
Can't convert, but he'll go to the line for two.
Come on, there you go.
Down the first one.
We are much better at making our free throws than the other team is.
And he'll come away one of two.
Yeah, I say that as I miss.
With some difficulties.
And we're still better.
Houston lobs it to the low block. That last
there you go.
Was off by number 35. To the free throw line. Robertson backs
in. He's here. Oh, look at that. Abuse that mismatch.
Bounces high, but falls through.
I thought I was a losing team. No, I'm winning. I'm winning. I won't have to worry about that. After that amazing first half I had, we were up 439, I think it was, 39-11. So
Houston
we're doing good.
Dumps it to the inside. Nice move in the paint on that last shot by Plummer. You just can't give anybody that much room when they're right at the basket.
There you go.
Like
there you go.
Sank the basket.
Plow on through.
To the line for one more. Foul shot is good for a three-point play. Plummer inbounds the ball. 2:59
nice.
Left in the game. Pass. High post.
RIP image. What happened? Oh, no.
Gets the inside shot. He's 2-for-6 for the game.
There we go.
He's double teamed. Dendry.
Ah.
Feet and steps
it's all right.
On the line.
Whatever.
We're going the other way. The
Tigers
they will
put, all my,
different look out
put there. All my other guys back in.
Jones brings it up court.
Dude, this Turner dude, I cannot wait to get rid of him.
Hands it off.
I'm hoping to God that I get some of those small forwards to join me. So I don't even have to worry.
Last basket was nailed by Hawk. Jones has the ball. They're bringing the double team. Has it left wing. The triple.
Oh, yes.
That was a much quicker shot than they might have liked, but it was a pretty open look.
Oh, he missed. That's all right.
Misfired on that last three.
Oh,
the Retrievers are really struggling. When a shot like that comes around, you've got to hit it.
Is that another Idolmaster one, Jack? I take an assumption that it is. Oh, brisk iced tea. I have not had brisk iced tea in God knows how long.
Knocks down the first one.
Especially the lemon flavor one. It's nice. There was a thing on our anime about who your most unconventional best girl is, and I got quite a few points for being like, yeah, no, Lizbeth is better than Asuna. I got a lot of points because I was speaking the truth. Yeah, I knew you were gonna. I knew as soon as you said that. I'm like, and then I'm like, I bet it's a cat. I just bet it's a cat.
Rose throws it up, drops it in from beyond the arc. They're now out in front.
Freaking that karma. But it's true. Most people are awesome of people. Or Sinon. Not enough people into that right into that Lisbeth scene.
Nice little crossover. Number 35. Turner has it. And that's his fourth rebound thus far.
That's what I call
I was also going to mention L85 from Yupote.
You saw the result.
But,
The shot down low.
I forgot about doing that. God damn it. Turner can't do anything right. Nothing. Thank God we were already up by 35 freaking points. Otherwise, it wouldn't have mattered.
The Tigers were the last ones to touch it, and they'll turn it over. The Tigers will get a few of their starters back in the game. Number 35 inbounds the ball.
I don't think they can come back. There's too far to climb in too short a time.
Beats it to the wing. That one was drilled by
someone mentioned like their best girl being Monami from Oreimo, which I was like, okay, sure, explain.
They should hold on to the lead, Vern.
Because usually when it comes to the stuff that Monami did in Oreimo, you're either like fully in the camp of, yeah, she should have done that, or fully in the camp of, no, that's completely heartless and shitty to do.
Let's it go.
Never really seen much of a middle ground where it's like, yeah, probably not, but probably maybe. It's like, no, she should have done that. That's weird. Or like, no, she absolutely shouldn't have done that. Heartless cunt. Like, something like that.
The Retrievers, 67-46.
Nice. Barring the ending of Oreimo, Monami's been a nice girl for most of the series. Well, I mean, the whole thing that they were doing was that this was like part of her the theory of how this all worked out. Apparently, it was a little more blatant than like the manga and light novels, but like the whole thing was about like her being jealous of Kirino, and so she decided to take Kyosuke and dumb him down to her level and the way it, you know, and basically make him more normal instead of this extraordinary human being that Kirino was in love with and decided, like, oh, well, this is the way I'm going to have him, by making him somebody who's undesirable. And when that eventually backfired, then that's when she decided to fight Kirino. That's how it's described why she's, like, an awful human being. Is it around the NCAA? No. God damn it. Tournament tree. Okay, so 25th and then 27th. All right. How did Syracuse and USC end up in here too? It's really weird. You got like Appalachian State, UW Green Bay, then you have fucking Illinois. I fear dragging her down to her level is a bit contrived, though. That's the whole, like, the people who are in the camp of like, she's a piece of shit, is fully in the camp of, well, she dragged him down from being this extraordinary human being that he apparently was when he was a kid, because, you know, he used to do sports and shit, and then he decided not to do sports and stuff when he started hanging out with Monami. So He basically dumbed him down and made him less desirable. That's how they feel happened. I knew it was going to be Illinois, by the way. This one might not turn out so well. I guess we'll find out. Making someone to be a bigger part of your life isn't a fair. I know. Those are the people who are in the camp of the fact that this was all some like devious plan to take Kyosuke from his sister. Like, and it's one of those things that the more you hear about it, the more you say it, it's like, oh no, how dare she not want his own sister to fall in love with him and try to do things with him. Yes, that's totally terrible. It is one of those things. It's like, it's either she did nothing wrong or she's the devil. I've never seen anyone in the camp of, maybe she shouldn't have done this or this, but you know, she's not all bad. It's just the, you know, something the author came up with when he felt done with the series. Yeah. Because there wasn't any nefariousness, like, even hinted at until, Jesus, the tail end of the second season. Like, and it really was, like, just what? A single scene? Like, the whole thing was, like, a single scene of, like, her telling her sister, oh, it's wrong to love your brother. You know, and it's, like, all of that is apparently based off of a single scene. Like, that whole, like, episode 13, which was meant to make Kirino more likable, which I was long past that point at that point anyway. Because it's like, you don't do two full seasons of her being a bitch and then just do one episode and assume that it's going to be A-OK. It's like, no, there's a reason for it. Here. Monami's the bitch. There. Hate her. Oh, dude, it bounced off his fucking dome. Good job, oh, that was terrible. Number 32. And they now go up by two. Passes it to the right side. I hadn't seen the video in a while, but I ended up seeing the video again of Jushin Liger going into the hotel rooms of people like Tanahashi and Makabe and Honma and trying to pin them in their sleep. And people were kind of talking about that. It was kind of like I had seen a small discussion on it where they were just like, man, even in his sleep, Tanahashi kicks out at one. And Hanma eats the pin. Of course, Hanma's the one to eat the pin. Got it. Got it. With their ability to rebound effectively, he wants to make sure they stay active on the offensive glass. Thank you, Tracy. Just like that promo was going to make room. Yeah, dude. Who thought that was a good idea? Okay, so we're going to take Roman Reigns, and he's going to spout exposition at a Chicago crowd for 5 minutes, and then he's going to have an 8-minute match with Braun Strowman. What the fuck? Who decided that? Wait, how come they can have the thing and we can't when we were in the last one? Oh, well. Gets the second to fall as well. All right. Makes his first appearance. We're keeping up. We're keeping ourselves there.
Number 32 inbounds the ball. Right around 10 minutes left in the half.
Wait, what? You practically... I missed inside. Something.
Let's it go.
Oh, bullshit. Oh, okay.
He misses the first.
Wow. Even Illinois is missing. Then again, it is their center. Probably didn't value all that free throw shooting power when they were trying to get a good center.
Rose,
not to mention it's Illinois and they're in the NIT, so there's probably a reason.
Beats it to the wing. Rose.
Oh.
Number 25 snatches it up. Well, he can hit that, but it's not really.
Paige is going to be on Conan. Oh boy. Hand in his face. Seems interesting. I wonder why she's going to be on Conan. Are they going to be? Is she going to be promoting that crappy ass Christmas movie? Dude, you know what? If they were going to have a second guest with Paige, Sarah Silverman's perfect for that because she Paige. Anything I've seen of Paige where she's not wrestling, she's basically like WWE Sarah Silverman.
Gets the three-pointer to go. He's 1-for-2 from three-point range.
I can absolutely foresee some things happening that's going to get Paige in trouble. You know how many times we had to use dump out of what she said?
Left side. Dendrick backs him down. Number 32 snatches the rebound. They're bringing the double team.
I mean, the last time Sarah Silverman was on Conan, she did the lips trick where you take like a screen, like you make your lips like real thin, stick out your tongue a little bit and like take a screenshot of it and then you can make it look like a fucking vagina. Like, I know that's on Conan. That's what Sarah Silverman did. That's the bit Sarah Silverman did. That's what she opened with last time she was there. So, I think that'd be interesting, because I don't... To be fair, though, they do... Because The Miz is in the same movie, so it seems kind of... Maybe they're just trying her out as a okay, how can she handle the media? It would be interesting, like, because it's one of those things to me. It's like, Miz is well-spoken enough, and he's done movies before, and it seems kind of odd that they wouldn't pick Miz. But, you know, maybe they're just trying to see what Paige can do.
Pass, left wing.
PR guy they stick her with is going to sweat bullets, of course.
Backs down.
I remember they had just come out with a video where she was on, like, Periscope or something, and some guy had just said, fuck you. So she said, fuck you. And then she pans over to Scott Armstrong immediately, and Scott Armstrong's like, you cannot say that. She's like, sorry. And I think Steve Austin said something about Paige, too, where he said that his next podcast with Paige needs to be, like, on his, like, normal podcast, not the network thing, because apparently between the two of them, there were so many curses and F-bombs going off before the actual network thing, that he's like, nah, I think we would have to have it on, like, the Unleashed podcast.
Off target on the last layup.
I like the idea that she's engaging trolls, though, on you. I like the idea that Paige is just like, oh, like someone just says, fuck you. Like, I imagine Paige is now, fuck you, too. Like, why would you engage those people?
He's double teamed.
I mean, there's a female on Twitter who's just devoted to sexually harassing the male performers in the most insane of ways.
Robertson inbounds the ball.
Oh my! Oh wow, that worked. That worked. Take advantage of it. There you go. There you go. Oh, he lost the ball. That's all right. Just don't let him. All right, he scored, but that's all right. Still up by four. Totally a trait. Yeah, I can. And she's British. She's British, and she has, and the way her parents are, and the way I've seen stuff with her parents, it's like. It doesn't surprise me that she would have a dirty mouth. I've seen enough stuff with her mother. I mean, shit, I've had that before. Like, even with my own mother, where I'll say something and my mom is like, where? She's like, why would you swear? It's like, I learned it from you. You swear like a sailor.
I like this decision. The guys he's putting out there play very well together.
Come on, pass to him, pass to him. Oh, no, you weren't going to pass to him.
Rice takes it up, catches the nice lead pass and strong.
Shit, okay.
And hits the layup. They're now behind by four. Passes to the free throw line. Dandridge backs in.
There you go. There you go.
Pulls the trigger. The shot bounced up and in.
Got it in.
By Robertson.
And
they now lead by six.
I'm going to go with, for that picture, really Love strong. Live. Obviously in the K-On's Light Music Club. It might still be more Idolmaster. I don't know if you're posting He's Love Live up. Or not, or Idolmaster. I don't.
Beats it to the high post.
I need to maybe check that.
Number 32 grabs the offensive rebound. They rule this one goaltending. Count the shot.
Wait, that was goaltending? Let me see this shit again. Oh, because his hand went through and it was already kind of on its way down, I guess. Balls. There we go.
Catches it, baseline. Feeds outright. Backs down. Higgins.
There you go. Oh, damn it.
Jumper to four. But they're still up by four.
All right, that's out. We're still up by four. We'll be fine.
Number 33.
We're still okay.
Dumps it off. Number two.
Don't need to freak out yet. No. That's not good. That's all right. We just need to make a shot. Gotta stay up. Gotta stay up.
Catches it. Right wing. Dendrick backs in.
We'll be fine. We'll be fine. Pick and roll. Please pick and roll off me. Thank you. Oh, did that work? Okay, good. I didn't expect the center. I should have expected the center to come at me, but I wasn't 100% sure it was going to happen. I didn't know if I was going to get my man off me or not and be able to get a nice open three like that. That's exactly what I wanted.
Is definitely aware of that problem. He told his assistants that they have to have more defenders
damn.
Into the paint, even
damn.
If it means leaving the perimeter open. Desperate measures here, Vern.
Thanks, Tracy.
Screwy, screwy, screwy.
There
we go. Just start with a rapid fire. Rapid fire buckets. It's all right. As long as we're trading them. All right. Up by 7. It's all right. I can do that. I can deal with that.
Coach Wilson made some changes that could affect their chemistry a little bit. I don't think these guys have played together very often.
All right.
Colbert inbounds the ball. Here comes.
You know what I keep forgetting to do? I keep forgetting to actually play Fighting Climax online. Now that I'm actually on American servers, I can play that shit online, and I desperately need to. I'd like to judge myself against other people and see how well I do. That's going to fail. Oh, my God. Oh, damn. We played one game online and won. Nice.
Quick defensive reaction changed the trajectory.
That's what great defenses do.
I played one of my buddies. Brought it over to his house because I figured he wanted to play. I was right. Played a whole bunch of matches. We traded off. I was winning at first, and then I just kept kind of failing, and then we started just trading off wins a lot.
Number 33 gets it.
Just various different characters. Silveria is nuts as a character, I'll tell you that much. As a character, Silveria is just insane. Oh my God.
Pulls it in. They're still up by 5. Hill takes the shot. Can't hit from the left wall.
Nice. All right.
Robertson.
There you go.
Down.
Abuse that mismatch.
Swish. And they go up by 7. 2:29 left in the first half.
Oh, come on. I also decided finally to actually post one of my TEW videos because the TEW stream I did a couple nights ago, I finally got uploaded and put on YouTube and everything, and I put it on that Fantasy Booker subreddit. It's pretty interesting. Mine seems to be a lot different than how the rest of, you know, everyone on the subreddit seems to do stuff, because most of them aren't live, if not just about all of them. They don't really have the chat because they're not live. And they tend to focus more on the events rather than kind of like how I do it, where it's like I do all the boring stuff where you see like every little day. It's like, oh yeah, let me just do every little thing on stream, you know, it's fun. I don't know how boring it is. A lot of people just focus on the events themselves. Since I post the whole stream up, it's just kind of, you just basically see the sausage being made.
Backs down. Hobbs catches it. Out
makes
left.
For a much longer video.
Passes. Left wing.
Yeah. And I'm pretty much the only one who actually does, well, because of the fact that I'm live and I hate, like, the whole silence thing, and I don't feel like I should just be sitting there the entire time just practically silent as I'm thinking. I'm the only one with, like, music, too. Not to say anything, any of that is bad at all with the other ones. Or it's even bad for me. It's just different. I don't know, David, what happened? You just found something really dumb, didn't you?
He'll go to the line for 2 shots.
Oh, shit.
He misses the first. Both teams are making a few lineup changes.
Over 2 pounds of Chef Boyardee without even noticing? What? Well, you ate that?
He sinks the second. Morgan inbounds the ball.
Someone was hungry, someone was high.
Dicing pass. Great pass.
You know, he does live in Florida. I'm sure he can find whatever he needs there. right. This is a good. This is a good first half right now.
Number 25.
Doing all right. Good.
That's his third rebound of the contest. Hobbs takes.
Oh yes.
Off a sweet lead pass. They now lead by 11.
Just threw two cans in the pot.
With the score, 42.
15 ounces each can. Jesus.
Give us your opinion on the first half, Bill.
If we don't I see thought I was a fat soon, ass because I threw in some reach. Popcorn. Well, I didn't throw in popcorn. I got like that pre-pop stuff that you can get at like a grocery store where it was like movie theater butter popcorn. And it was like 3.5 ounces.
Player of the half.
Who's your I was like, wow, why am I so bloated?
Tremendous effort from our player of the half.
Oh my God. Okay. Well, since it's halftime, real quick, I'm going to be right back. I'm going to take a pee. Too much soda and tea. Right back. All right. There we go. DiceQ.net is the future of the localizing anime game related talk show now. I don't think I've ever heard of DiceQ.net.
We're all set to begin the second half, so let's get back into it.
I'm just now getting back into the world of torrenting.
Inbounds it to start the second half. Swings it to the left wing.
Oh, look at that.
Puts it up. The 11-footer was good by Dandridge.
Perfect.
He's 4-for-6 for the game.
Damn.
The Illini will
That's
retain
right.
possession. Let's send it down to Tracy Wilson.
Well, at halftime, I talked to Coach Wilson. He felt it wouldn't be classy to run up the score and was going to change things in a way.
I feel like I should watch some sort of idol show. I don't know why, but I feel like there's enough of them that that's one genre I haven't really given it much of a chance yet. That should be one. I'll have to either be like Love Live, Idol Match. Miss Monochrome doesn't seem too bad either. Like either, you know, one of those. Love Live. Idol Masters or Miss Monochrome. Because I've seen some stuff from Miss Monochrome, just like bits. just tiny bits. It didn't seem all that bad.
Bricks it off the back of the rim. That was a much quicker shot than they might have liked.
But oh, I screwed that up. Wow, why did my other team take a dive? Try the first episode of Cinderella Girls, then the first episode of Lullaby Season 2. Of course, I would probably have to ask. Obviously, with Cinderella Girls, I heard it's, you know, different. Would I need to worry about Love Life Season 1?
Dendridge has it left side.
Oh, my God. It's all right. Just keep calm. Keep calm.
Traffic, but the D was too good, even for him on that one.
Dumps it to the inside. The jumper was buried by Culver.
So it's the same. So from what I'm getting from that, is that it's the same story and stuff, but nothing really tends to happen.
Knocks down the trifecta. He's shooting 66% from downtown.
Or at least not enough happened that would make season one worth it. Season one is the formation of their group. It's really shitty compared to season two. That sucks. Especially considering you would assume like a nice origin story would be really good. You never know.
Gets it right wing.
It's kind of like superhero movies. I guess the origin stories are always crap.
That's his third rebound of the contest. Number 25 beats it to the right side. Low block.
Oh, you bitch.
Fouled, and he'll go to the line.
Beautiful. 1 second is they're doing that.
And get to the line for the three opportunity.
I had to open up my door just a bit there so my home room doesn't smell like dude sweat.
About 9.5 minutes left in the second half.
Just get some nice airflow going.
Him down. Number 32 pulls it down.
Nice work by the big fella to get that rebound.
Let's not let them catch up, guys. Can we do that, please? I would love it if we don't, you know, if we can just kind of hold ourselves together. Just a wee bit.
Bounces it to the right corner.
Oh, damn it.
Rebound by Colbert.
Now we're fucking up. That's not good. Come on.
Number 25 takes the shot.
Oh. Now they're down by 2. We really need to watch what we're doing. Cuz it's all going to hit the fan if we can't make this work. There you go. Oh my God, he couldn't hit that. He's got no range.
The break is on. It's picked off by Dendridge. Not a good entry pass, Fern. You just can't
pass it
in there.
There you go. Shot from 19 feet made by Rose. Let's ruin that momentum of theirs. Swing it back our way.
Build it back up. He's doubled up. Throws it up. The triple was off the mark.
There you go. Swing that back our way.
Tosses it up.
Make it work for us.
Not the look he wanted to there, Bill.
I wouldn't let him have too many more of those. He can light you up in a hurry.
Nice.
By Rose. Number 32 inbounds the ball.
I'm on this really awful kick of finishing a series and then adding two more to my plan to watch list. It's like, oh, I'm going to check this out. And I really want to check this out. Oh, I literally haven't really watched any anime in the last, like, 2 weeks.
He gets them both. Number 2 is needed out on the floor. He didn't get much of a rest.
I've had to do a bunch of training videos and stuff at work. It's a bunch of like web seminar things, so it's all web-based stuff, so I just got to sit there at my computer and read and
skip pass. Left
then of course take a little quiz.
They're now down by 5. About 7.5 minutes left in the second half.
Come on.
Dendridge backs down. Has it outright. Wheeler passes to the wing.
Oh, that worked.
They're up.
Webinar. Yeah. I mean, they're not exactly webinars, though, because we have webinars that we have to do.
Passes it back to the left block.
Yeah, we have things that they call. It's like, yeah, it's webinars. It's like, I don't care. I'm only doing this because I'm getting paid to do it.
Wheeler backs him down. Knocked loose.
Oh, bullshit.
Lays it right in. The Tigers will take their first timeout. The Tigers will make some substitutions.
All right. You would be helping out this team greatly if you do not bring in Turner at all. Just don't let that albatross around the team's neck show his face in this game.
Gets the second chance basket to go. And they're out in front by six. Here's the double team. Unloads from 10 feet.
Oh, damn it. If I had just not worried about the block, I'd have been able to get that.
They've got their defense and it's minimum.
Ah, it worked. Through all that idiocy, we managed it somehow. Come on. Slow them down. Slow them down. I feel if we can beat... if we could beat Illinois right here, we could beat just about anybody.
Skips it to the wing. Robertson catches it on the elbow. Backs down. Hobbs releases.
There you go.
Knocks it down from 3-point range. They push the lead to 9. Pulls the trigger. Tried to answer back with a 3, but it's missed by number 33.
He might have been thrown off by how wide open he was.
Come on. Come on. Ah, that's my fault for using a point guard to back down.
Wheeler backs him down.
There you go. Oh, I should have gotten a little bit closer.
But they still lead by
just back him all the way down.
Leads him with the pass. The quick shot was hit by Rice.
All right. They've got it within 7-point game.
Just over 5 minutes left in the second half.
Let's make this...
Wheeler gets it right wing.
Come on, Rose. Damn.
Miss there. He is human. They still have a 7-point lead.
When the web ends up, yeah, that'd be nice.
To the right. Outside. Passes to the right side. They're going to double team him.
Blech.
Rice kicks it out to the perimeter. Brought in by Rose.
Jesus. All right. All right.
Backs down.
Oh, backing him down just a little bit.
From the right block.
Oh, damn it.
Shot. Both teams are going to make some substitutions.
That shouldn't have happened. That should have gone in. Why'd he spin that way?
Colbert inbounds the ball. Number 33 has it right side.
Oh yeah, remember when we were talking about stupid like when we were talking about in the NCAA football thing, the stupid team names and crap, and like we were like, what's an Aggie? What the fuck is a Fighting Illini? I just thought about that. I was like, okay, the Aggies is something that seemed to have been made up, but what the fuck is a Fighting Illini? I don't even get that.
Left wing. Top of the key.
I wonder what their mascot raises is. Up. I really want to know what the Fighting Illini's mascot is. I want to believe it's just some dude in a Chicago t-shirt. Like, just, I don't know.
To the top of the key.
It's just, it's not even like a mascot, like a cool one. It's just a dude in an Illinois t-shirt.
The Illini will take a timeout.
Yeah, I'm doing a decent job not losing. Defense. We'll do defense.
Well, it looks like they're getting set.
All right, 331. We're up by 10.
Number 33 inbounds the ball.
It's an Indian thing, isn't it? Or at least at some point it was some sort of Indian. I don't think there wasn't an Illini tribe. But, you know, to each their own.
Top of the key. Rose has it left wing. Swing pass right wing. Number 25. No luck. Robertson passes it up.
Yeah,
court.
An Indian thing.
Be patient on offense. Good shots will come if you don't rush that.
Nice touch on that last three by Rose.
You know, considering the whole, like, oh, wow. That worked. All that worked. This is game over. This is game over.
He can't come away with a three-point.
Oh my God, we're gonna beat Illinois.
Number 25.
That's all right. Just pour time off the clock. That's all right. If there was ever a time to milk the clock, this is the point.
The physicality, powered it through the contact and hit.
Yeah, I was kind of weirded out now that because it's like one of those things that I remember. It's like, wait a minute, Illinois' like logo is literally just the word Illinois with a basketball. That does not tell me what a Fighting Illini is. Kind of like with Texas A&M is literally just a T with an A and an M on the underside.
2:30 left in the game.
Every league has to have one Indian name team. And apparently a bunch of dog name teams, too. I gotta say, the UBMC that I just faced, I didn't think that you'd name a team after them. I didn't think they'd name their team that. Like, Huskies is one thing, Bulldogs is another. It's like, alright. Huskies, Bulldogs, those are big, you know, mildly intimidating dogs. I'm sure there's a Pitbulls, something like that. What is UBMC called? The Retrievers. All right. I'm guessing their friggin' mascot is just a giant cartoon old yeller. Xavier Woods is doing his first Let's Plays on YouTube, doing part one of Until Dawn. That's 27 minutes long on YouTube. Nice.
Colbert inbounds the ball.
Making that extra money.
The reverse. Flips it in for two.
Maybe WWE's not paying him enough. That's how he's going to make his extra money, is he's going to get monetized that stuff.
Skips it to the baseline.
I just kind of felt like... I just thought it was kind of funny, just because that's kind of how the Let's Plays go, generally. Is people started doing Let's Plays once they started fucking with the YouTube rhythm. To make it so they didn't get paid per views, it was like for how long people were basically attentive to their shit. So the people who made like those short fun films that are like 3 minutes long weren't getting paid dick. They might have had a million views, but the fact is they weren't getting a whole lot of money because people aren't watching that much. So a lot of them had to start doing Let's Plays just because it's like, okay, no. Okay, two of you, like, got ready to post up and then didn't fucking do it. So I don't even know what to say to that. That's all right. Oh, there you go. Need that residual income. Do trumpet tutorials. Thanks, this PayPal.
Robertson passes it to the left wing. Dendrick backs down.
I'll be honest, I bet he could still probably make a decent living on... never mind. I was going to say if he leaves WWE, then I realized, oh shit, if he left WWE, he wouldn't be getting WWE dudes on his game show and on his channel anymore. That wouldn't be happening.
To the free throw line. Beats it to the outside.
There we go.
That's all for this one. Grambling knocks off the Illini. 76.
After all. That's 67. What I was wondering, because I seen like Champ, and then Champ wasn't there, and then
player of the game.
People weren't sure if it was Champ doing like the NL. He had a first round bye week. He's facing Kofi. Nice. I'm sure that's going to be fun.
With today's version of the Pontiac game changing.
Rollins loves to holler and scream, and he talked about the gamer rage that he gets at games. And then Kofi's like the number one trash talker I've ever seen. The single greatest video game trash talker ever, especially at football.
Use this shot to take off on a huge run.
He made Xavier Woods look legit, like he just, like he was going to end the New Day right there. He's like, fuck this, I don't want to ride with you no more. No, fuck that. Raffles his shirts on YouTube, yeah, that'd be cool. Alright, got a nice hard-fought victory over Illinois. I don't know how we managed that at all. You just barely walked away with a 9-point win. Who are we facing now? UW Green Bay. I'm guaranteeing you it's going to be South Carolina in the other one. South Carolina is going to beat Massachusetts, and then they're going to beat Towson. I haven't even heard of Towson before. Just every scummy YouTuber play. All right. So one more game before I decide on something else to do. I haven't done the Bigs 2 in a little while. I don't know if I want to do the Bigs 2. So hopefully I'm going to be facing Syracuse. All right. This shouldn't be hard. I've never heard of UW Green Bay. Oh, if Sasha wore it first, dude, that thing would be an up-up. All right, it's an up-up-down-down t-shirt worn by me on this YouTube channel. All right, the last few days here, we got 24 hours left, and right now it seems to be $45 for an autographed t-shirt. So here's what I did. I had Sasha Banks herself wear this t-shirt, and we're now selling it for $7,000. That is the current bid, $7,000. And now it's just gone up to $7,500. All right. People get weird when it comes to that stuff. It's odd. Oh, come on. If we hit $10,000 total donated, I'll be doing a Razor Naga raffle.
Number four.
Oh, my God.
Dishes it to the left side.
Remember, if we hit $10,000 for this raffle, we're going to be auctioning off her ring-worn gear.
Catches it outright. Let's it go.
Don't worry, we're not going to be creepy. It's just a knee pad. And we're still selling it for $7,000. What the hell, people?
Swing pass. Left wing. Love.
It's a knee pad.
Has it on the elbow. Low. Backs in.
Bro, you mean I can sniff Sasha's knees?
Robertson dumps it inside. The last shot laid in by Higgins. He has a great feel for the game, and it's time.
I just thought of a terrible joke. All right. Then next up in the bid, we will fly you out to where we will give you tickets to the next WWE show where you can personally sniff Mikazi's fingers. That's right, Mikazi's fingers.
Was no good by number 32. But they're still out in front by 2.
And that's going for 15,000 already. Wow. See, that's why I said it was terrible.
Just over 10 minutes left in the half.
They're you have to advertise that Bailey's hair touched it.
Tough pass.
You can post the PayPal link so I can. That is a terrible, terrible thing. How much? Oh, damn it. Do that again. There you go.
That last three ball was drained by Rose. The D took too much time to set up, and it sure cost them. May hands it off. Hangs. It's blocked.
Oh,
get
nice.
There, big fella. You have to protect the lane, and that time.
Oh, damn it.
The big guy has spoken.
I can only imagine what happened once they start selling off, like, Bailey anything. Like, any. Just like a headband. Just a headband. I want to see them auction off one of Bailey's headbands, because I feel like there's a few thousand dollars in that. There's probably a few thousand dollars in a Bailey headband if it was worn by her.
Number four.
Oh, shit.
He found a little wiggle room and went aggressive to the rack. Extremely effective.
Come on. Come on.
swings it to the left wing. Love. Good look by Lowe. But they still trail by one.
It'd be this, you know what? It'd be funny. It'd be the same two creepy guys who were selling, like, who were buying, like, everything AJ and Paige for thousands of dollars. Bring out some reserves. That would be them. It would be the same two people.
About 8.5 minutes left in the half.
Dude who spent $15,000 on a ring-worn Paige shirt and, like, an autographed Paige belt. Like a Divas title belt autographed by Paige. I don't even want to imagine what said person is doing with a $7,000 ring-worn Paige shirt. But it's probably not framing it. Putting it up like, yeah, this is nice memorabilia. I just decided it was a one-of-a-kind item, and I just put it up here on this nice little frame.
Has it right wing. Rose pulls the trigger. Wheeler reels it in. Off target on the last layup.
There's nothing you can do but shake. No,
it'd be more like, oh, I see. You seem to have a picture frame of you seem to have something framed of Paige worn ring shirt. That's kind of cool. I don't see it. Like, are there wires inside to keep it standing up, or no? It's just standing up on its own. What? Don't worry about it. It's just standing up on its own.
He's double teamed.
Takes the shot. He got that whistle came long before I got there. This is bullshit. They want me to lose.
Gets the one to tie it. This next one would put them in front.
I feel like I'm not getting my dues here. That is a K Love.
One of two. Dendridge backs
up. There you go. Nice. Have I made things awkward yet? Cangelina Love.
Pass outright. He's doubled up.
Buying sweaty shirts worn by some attractive athletes, you're overthinking things.
Gets it, baseline. Lowe tosses it up, nails the jump shot. Grambling takes its first time out of the game.
It's a collectible, obviously.
The Tigers will get a few of their starters back in the game.
Why would you think I'd do something so nefarious?
Robertson inbounds the ball. Copeland was out of bounds.
What the fuck?
That will cost them possession.
He lost track of where
I hate that people literally have like tens of thousands of dollars to throw away on Paige merchandise.
The Phoenix will try to
on autographed ring-worn Paige merchandise.
Here comes the double team.
Because the amount of money that they're spending on a Paige T-shirt that was worn by her in a match, I could like fix my car and get a nice car with that amount of money. And they're spending it on a T-shirt.
Snatched off the defensive glass
because a 22-year-old British girl
sure
wore
like
it.
Open next time, believe me, he's going to make them pay for it.
Oh, look at that.
The finger roll to fall. They're up 11-9.
Oh, damn.
Right around 6 minutes left in the half. Knocks it loose, but it's recovered by Wisconsin Green Bay. Lowe backs down.
I feel like there's a couple of times there I should have had at least a block or some good defense or there. Like, that one shot in and of itself was good. Look at that. That was great defense, but what I just did earlier wasn't. I don't understand that.
Lowe has it left wing.
Damn. Better than sitting on until you're dead, I guess. But, like, my thing is, I could fix shit. I could fix shit that I need fixed right now if I had that money.
He gets them both.
Damn.
Dumps it to the paint. In the key, the basket
was nailed
by Hobbs. And we're now all tied up 13. Just over 5 minutes left in the half. They're going to double
team. Come on.
Garrett takes it up. Great finishing traffic.
Boy, I don't know why they seem to be doing a hell of a lot better than Illinois was. It's not like they're all that fantastic, really.
Hobbs puts it up. Misses the long one.
The defense sit on the page shirt.
That shot. Good job closing on the shooter. Catches it out left. Lowe backs him down.
Just sit on the page shirt. Or if you have enough money, try to pay Page to sit on you.
Rotating over to block that.
You can't lose concentration.
Oh, shit. There we go.
For a second.
Robertson dumps it off. Sent away violently. Left wing. Passes to the left. They're bringing the double team.
Ah, that was bad. They had a double team going, and I didn't think they were going to do that. So it was too late by the time I actually was going to go up for the shot.
Really affected that shot.
I love the defense. Just because he's in tight doesn't mean you have to give up the easy
Boom, there it is. All right. Let's swing this back the other way here. Oh, right through his legs.
Phoenix turned this one over out of bounds.
They were just
Oh god, is that a Tammy Sitch thing? I totally forgot about that. You could pay like $100 to like curl in bed with her.
It looks like they're playing man-to-man.
I'm pretty sure, like, I'm pretty sure Sonny at that point, like, all you have to do is slip her a few hundred extra bucks, you'd probably do whatever. Like, listen, I already paid $100, and I'm already here. Is that her name? Yeah, she used to be Sonny.
Down low.
Oh my god.
By Wisconsin Green Bay.
Not a good entry pass, Fern. You just can't force it in there.
Oh, Sonny. She legit in 1990, like six or seven, was the most searched, the most AOL searched, like celebrity on the planet. Which, back then, was a huge deal, because AOL was a huge deal, and then, like, searching for someone like that. And she took a fan seriously on what they'd pay for her to shit in a bag and send it. It's probably just one of those things where she's sitting there going, it's a little different, but now whatever floats your boat, I guess. I need money. Please give me money. You want pictures of me shitting in it? I'll do that. Oh no. Yeah, I figured.
Snatches the rebound. They've still got.
She was hot in the mid-90s.
The shot. The 9-footer was missed by number 4.
And then she's that.
Still a double-digit game.
She didn't take to Candido dying well. To be fair, she was kind of a mess before Candido. Before Candido died, wasn't she? I particularly remember her being a bit of a mess long before that. Because didn't she do that weird, like, Wrestling Vixens DVD in, like, 2001 or 2 or something like that? I can't remember when it was, but...
Coach Wilson may have to deal with some chemistry issues after
I think she was a... I think she was...
Inexperienced lineup out there.
Yeah, I think she was kind of doing that shit beforehand, and Candido didn't die till like, 2005. I don't know when the Wrestling Vixens thing was, but...
That's an over and back violation.
Obviously, I just know about Ahmed Johnson and cocaine.
That happens every once in a while.
She in the Hall of Fame? Yes, she is. Cause she's the original diva. Of course she's in the Hall of Fame.
Has it left wing. Shoots a three. Corralled by number 32.
China cannot get into the Hall of Fame because she does porn. Sonny's in and she shits in bags and people pay for her shit.
Errant last shot by Love.
She's basically a prostitute, but they're not actually saying it. She managed to not become an embarrassment. Yeah, good point. To be fair, though, she was doing embarrassing shit even before she was inducted. That was the thing. She cleaned herself up just long enough to look good for the induction, and that was kind of it. I remember there was a lot of shit coming out originally, like, leading up to her induction. Like, up to, like, a year before, and then she kind of, like, died off for a year. Like, not a lot of, like, nothing really, no Tammy Sitch stories came out for, like, a, like, 6 or 7 months or so. And then we're like, okay, what happened to her? Did she die? What happened? And then it was like, oh, she's going to go into the Hall of Fame. And then she looked good for the Hall of Fame, and she was fine, and she looked like a reputable member of society, and then did her shit again.
Robertson inbounds the ball.
Oh, wrong person. Hey, it worked. I think.
To the baseline.
Yep.
Robertson backs him down.
Oh, this dude. Fucking hell.
Shoots from the post. It's good.
There you go.
He's got two. The Phoenix with some difficulty.
Trying to add a better impact than Sonny. All Sonny was doing, yeah, managing whoever his champion.
Passes it up court.
And barely, too. Like, it was mostly Candido, and then she was just kind of off. Was she, like, a manager after Candido? Who was she managing between... Okay, between the Body Donnas and the LOD thing, what was she doing? Because I don't remember her managing anybody in particular. Like, I don't remember her managing anybody in particular. I just remember her being there. She just existed.
He gets them both. Dendry inbounds the ball.
All right.
They're playing a 3-2 zone. Your big men have to
be alert when they come out. Fuck it. You're not going to guard me. I'll take a shot. They're chanting, let's go, Sheamus.
Here comes the double team. 43 seconds in the first half. Passes. Low block.
Oh. Got it.
Big fella. You have to protect the lane, and that time they tried to steal
it through on. Yep, there we go. All right, nice.
Hook three.
Oh, swing that momentum back the other way. We're both hot.
Fans are going nuts, Fern. Could this building get any louder?
We're gonna blow the roof off of this arena, leading into halftime.
Number 32 uses the crossover. Scores after the quick crossover. They make it a single-digit game.
All right. 30 to 21. My, what a low-scoring game this has been. But I'll take it.
Give us your opinion on the first half.
She's probably like the Hornswoggle bite. I was like, wasn't she just basically like shooting t-shirts into the crowd? Wasn't that basically? James Storm wasn't signed. He's working on the India thing with TNA. Oh. Good riddance. Oh, come on. I think James Storm would have been good. James Storm would have been a good addition. Hell, he probably would have been a good addition to the Wyatt family.
We're all set to begin the second half.
There's a lot of people in TNA right now I wouldn't really care for being in WWE, but James Storm's one of those guys. It's like, eh, that's cool. Why not? Wouldn't be my first pick, or second or third, but hey. He's skilled enough.
Thank you, Tracy.
Oh my god, how did you miss that? There we go. Should have brought the Revolution over.
Smooth taking it in.
They just keep the whole Revolution thing going in NXT, like as if Impact doesn't exist.
Gets it, left wing. Number four. Skip.
It's like, hey, we're doing that on another nationally televised show. What nationally televised show?
Bank shot won't fall. Simple conversion, and somehow it
nice.
Those are the kind
no,
of
not nice.
For a while. They're going to double team him.
I'm excited for NXT so I could see the James Storm thing. I really want to see James Storm in NXT. I just want to see at least that one match. You not want to use Ogan say he can do a stupid thing, but a 40-year-old who only made his name in TNA with barely passable personality.
Shot clock
I'm feeling like you, like, okay, James Storm was the shit. I don't know what you're talking about with borderline personality or whatnot, but Beer Money was gold. Beer Money was the shit. And James Storm was a big part of that because Bobby Roode doesn't have much of a personality. And I'm not even saying he does that thing where he's going over dudes. Like, because the way they could have made it is, like, he's a veteran like Rhino, where, like, but he's, like, lesser than Rhino, where it's like, okay, well, he can be in there and he can work with the younger guys. He doesn't have to go over people. Yeah, the Revolution thing was actually pretty good. I mean, it's booked like shit. I mean, that's just how it is. Singles James Storm is good. It really was.
Out left. Dendrick backs down. Passes it to the wing.
Ah, that's a toss-up with him of whether or not he's actually going to make it. But it seems like more often than not he's actually making it, so that's pretty good.
Here's the double team. Skips it to the top of the key. Nearly had a chance for a three-point play, but he'll go to the line for two.
Like, I wouldn't be huge on, like, him doing the Joe thing where he's, like, going over people and he's, like, going to be in the title hunt and all that other crap.
Knocks down the first one. The Tigers will bring out some reserves.
That'd be a little bit different.
He gets them both.
We should sign Chris Hero now that he's fat. Oh my god.
Wheeler has it in the paint. He gets hammered. He'll head to the
spot. I mean, Hero can still work, but he just looks like a mess.
And he makes the first. McKinney is needed out on the floor. He didn't get much of a rest.
I don't know. I'm just thinking James Storm probably could have, because, like, it's that thing where you know how you have, like when you're doing Tough Enough, like the old versions of Tough Enough, you had the veteran guys in there to, you know, work with the young guys and kind of build them up, and guys who kind of know how to work, how to react to the. I mean, this is a dude who doesn't have to do the NXT thing of like. Work of like learning how to do the camera thing and all that, because like he worked TV, he knows about the cameras and shit, and
number four,
you know, but he could do that thing where he's putting over, he could do the Jericho thing where he's putting over the younger guys and working with them and getting them better.
The finger roll was laid in by number four.
I'm thinking like what would be cool is like Storm versus like Enzo Amore. Enzo's doing his thing. Storm doesn't know how to react to any of it because it's like, what the hell is this?
No good with the hook shot.
I bet you Enzo would come out of it a better wrestler, though.
Number four takes it up. Banks it off the glass and in. He's shooting 50% for the game. Copeland brings it up the floor.
Come on. All right.
Great pass.
Oh, my God. Where's the fouls? Oh, my good God. These can't all be clean blocks. I refuse to believe that everything that just transpired was a clean block. Because I'm getting calls on some serious bullshit. So don't be doing that. Don't be doing that crap to me. Wow, okay, now they're able to swat the ball away. Sure, why not? Jesus. What is this game's issue right now?
Passes it to
There's something going on.
Goes up,
of course he can make that. Take a fucking timeout. Jesus Christ. All right, defense.
Well, let's get back to the action. Both teams are making a few lineup changes.
Is it guaranteed that he's... I haven't seen anything today about James Storm working with the India thing. Did they... announced James Storm is going to be working with Impact for the India stuff. I didn't see anything on it, and I figured that would be one of those first things that they would say is, James Storm's not signed by WWE. He's working with Impact Wrestling. Like,
number four.
I didn't see anything about it. Trust me, I'm looking too. good. Ba, 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 oh my god. This is some bullshit.
Grambling has had serious problems with their interior defense.
And you say that with TNA not announcing it at all, something, yeah. Oh, it's a surprise! James Storm, like, he comes back an even bigger deal because he worked on NXT once.
Means leaving the perimeter open. Desperate measures here, Vern.
Thanks, Tracy. Oh, yes, Vern.
Like, it's like, oh my god, this man just worked up, like they'd say up north, but he was actually south. It's like, hey, I think this man worked somewhere else in Orlando recently. Huggala, huggala. This is some bona fide bullshit right now.
44-43. About 6.5 minutes left in the second half. Dendry backs down.
Apparently TNA Mecha knows it. Uh-huh. Well, that's TNA Mecha. Isn't fucking what's-his-nuts Bob Ryder, the dude who actually, like, helps run talent shit for TNA over there, and he spews a lot of bullshit, because I've heard about the TNA Mecha shit before.
Number 32 hangs in the air.
Because I've seen some straight up lies tweeted by TNA executives who happen to have a goddamn username and shit of their own on that website. So I'm not really gonna take anything that the TNA Mecha says, because that's basically like a TNA circle jerk.
The right people in the right places. It didn't happen there.
Last shot dropped in by Love. Grambling calls timeout.
Acting like Storm chose them over NXT. Yeah, sure. Not to mention, it would seem really, really weird for WWE and NXT to make any sort of big deal about James Storm, like, showing up. Because they, like, did the thing on Instagram and all that. It's like, James Storm is here. He's in NXT. And then, you know, it's a thing where it's, oh, well, you know, and then they would, like, Instagram pictures of it and all that. It's like, guess what? Guess who showed up in NXT? James Storm. And it's like, for some reason, I don't see him, like, working NXT for, like, one match and then being like, no, of course not. Like, if there was a contract thing that he didn't agree with, that he was somehow getting paid more with Impact, maybe I could see it. But I think he probably knows what a sinking ship looks like. So I don't put a ton of stock in that. And of course, if they're going to make such a big deal over James Storm being there, why would they make a big stink over him being there and then just be like, nah, we don't need you?
Garrett went after that rebound hard. Great work.
Yeah, sorry. We don't actually. It just seems weird. Because I haven't seen anything other than, like, I don't take anything TNA Mecha says. It's like, well, TNA Mecha said it, and it's like, yeah, but that's like,
Wisconsin Greenville calls time.
We have to take a pay cut once we get this Alberto thing locked in. We'll all be making a lot more money.
Getting set to inbound the ball. Both teams are going to make some substitutions.
I ended up seeing like an interview that Alberto did where he told about the conversation that he had with Triple H. And the conversation that he had with Triple H, it seems believable enough, to be completely honest, that I could totally see it being a thing where it's like, yeah, I totally believe Triple H would say something like that to Alberto. Vince Paul, TNA is going to finish TNA and NDM to Invasion Part 2.
Making the same kind of effort on that defensive end.
Except it would be even worse than the Invasion, the WCW Invasion. Because he just doesn't care. That's what we're going to see, like, at Survivor Series. It's like, they're going to do like a one-month Survivor Series storyline. Winner take all. It's going to start at Hell in a Cell.
Pointing to the defense.
It's the Brock Lesnar and the Undertaker. They're going at it. The Undertaker's about ready to tombstone Brock Lesnar. Then all of a sudden, fucking DJ Z just pops out from underneath the. My God, it's DJ Z!
Inside, up the backboard and in.
Holy crap, it's the man, Jesse Godders! Oh my God! I don't hate TNA, but I stopped watching after a while just because it's like, dude, I can't. These characters and these people and the booking and. He's got to lead TNA Invasion after the Catches Mania right main way. Event.
Backs in.
Oh my God.
Rose fires the three. Gets it to fall. The Phoenix call timeout. They're behind by 10.
Oh my God. Dude, game. I would love. Like dude, nothing would make me like. Nothing would be funnier than to hear the James Storm, since you guys like him and such, but the guy I saw
right.
wrestling NXT, number what he did four, after the match, he just reeked of mediocrity. That's the opinion of the song. Yeah, that's okay. Like, once again, everyone has their own opinion. Like, that's perfectly fine. I'm not trying to make you think, like, oh, if you say anything bad about James Storm, like, it's going to be, like... The dude's almost 40. He's never been an amazing wrestler, to be completely honest. Like, I'm gonna say you're gonna be like, and just say, yeah, Storm's never been an amazing wrestler, nor has he ever been in a, like, the shape that he's in right now is probably the best shape I've ever seen him in, because he almost always has a beer gut.
Left wing takes a three.
But I didn't mind, from what I had seen, and of course I didn't really watch much of Impact, I mostly watched highlights, but his Revolution stuff was pretty cool. You know? His matches were always okay. They were never mind-blowing. And I think with a nearly 40-year-old man, you're never going to get anything mind-blowing out of him unless his name's Jerry Lynn. And even then, you've pretty much seen every Jerry Lynn match once you've seen, like, the one he had with RVD. Like, I don't think he's going to be made out to be a huge deal. I think it's just because he's a huge deal because, like, in the realm of NXT stars, if you think about it, he's kind of on the same level as Samoa Joe due to the fact that, like, I don't think, obviously he's not the worker Joe is, and he can't go quite like Joe can, and he's not going to get pushed like Joe is. But if you think about it, they're both TNA stars. They were both on... Nationally broadcasted television for years, and it's just like it's a little bit different because it's one of those things that, like, because I've seen enough get off the fucking court, but it is one of those things that it's when you think about it, it's like, what's gonna sell tickets? Is Dash Wilder gonna sell tickets, or is a guy that you've seen on television on fucking Spike TV for years going to sell tickets? So I don't think they should make a huge deal out of them, but I don't think they're going to make a huge deal out of them. But of course, we'll see if he actually did join TNA. You never know. I mean, Bully Ray did that shit after Royal Rumble. But that's only because WWE wasn't interested in him right then and there. NXT doesn't really need anyone to sell tickets, to be completely honest. It is kind of more about the brand than people, but, you know, when you have someone who is kind of a nationally recognized name, I mean, he's not like a huge name, but if you've watched enough wrestling and you've at least maybe watched Spike or something, it's like, oh, I kind of remember James Storm, why not? I figured it's not an issue. I mean, they seem to sell out all the time. I mean, hell, they sold out Brooklyn, and I'm sure wherever they go, they're gonna sell out.
Gets it on the elbow. Number
32. It's just okay. Maybe not like tickets, but like think merchandise. Like maybe merchandise is the big thing because WWE loves their fucking merchandise. I would see better merchandise opportunities with a guy like James Storm, even if he was only in occasionally. You could still probably sell a lot more James Storm t-shirts than you would, like, hell, even Baron Corbin t-shirts. Holy crap, I won. While I was doing all that rambling about James Storm, we won.
Now let's go back to Greg Gumbel with today's version of the Pontiac game-changing...
I don't know. If they don't make too big of a deal out of James Storm, and if he is actually going to stay there, then I'll, you know, then I don't think there should be any real problem. Like, if he stays on the level of, you know, like, a guy who shows up to do a match per taping, something like that, that wouldn't be too bad. All right. So we're in the potentially final two games of the NIT Tournament. We have made it to the final four of the NIT Tournament. North Carolina and Towson. They stomped them, didn't they? Yeah, sort of. Yeah, we've been doing pretty good. So Syracuse, and then assumedly I'm gonna be facing North Carolina. Do they have Rhino I guess they don't have Rhino t-shirts. Huh. I don't know what kind of weird, odd deal that he has or anything like that. Maybe James Storm has the same deal. Who knows? If they feature him about as much as Rhino, then I'll be fine with that. You know, I don't see him being someone they're going to make a huge deal about. I see him kind of on that same level of Rhino, where it's like he's there and he can be, you know, a guy. A stepping stone for, you know, future talent to kind of be able to work with a veteran of 20 plus years and be able to kind of do some stuff with. What shocked me more than anything, and I don't know if it's still true, I'm pretty sure Rhino's not even 40. I wanna say Rhino's not even 40 technically. Okay, he's 40 now. He just turned 40 like last week. Just turned 40. That's amazing to me. Like, I thought Rhino was a lot older. Like, I thought Rhino was at least 5 years older than he actually is, just because he looked so much older when he was in TNA. Alright, I'm gonna stop the recording for this to put on YouTube. So for the people who watch this on YouTube, thank you very much. I'll be doing this again at some point, where we'll have our final four match against Syracuse. I'm not gonna guarantee a win, but hey, we beat Illinois, so maybe we might actually beat Syracuse. And then we'll be facing, I've gotta assume it's gonna be South Carolina in the finals of the NIT Tournament. It's weird to say, or North Carolina, it's really weird to say that North Carolina is in the NIT Tournament. I don't know how that happened or what injuries happened, but okay, that's a thing, I guess. All right.